Today, we're going to talk about narrative writing and how to get started on your first piece. Now remember, I know it might seem scary doing this at home, but your teacher is right here with you. Go ahead and find a good space where you think that you can focus on your writing. Make sure that you have a pencil and paper, or that you have your tablet open, or however you're planning on writing this story. Now that we've read the book, The Relatives Came, I want you to think about the story. This was an example of a narrative. What characters were in the story? Was it just one person? Or did the writer talk about a bunch of people? What details did the author include? Did they just say they drove in their car and then they drove home? No, they talked about all of the fun things that they did. There was a lot of details on eating dinner. And then, did the story stay on topic? And what I mean by that is, if the story is about the relatives coming to visit, they probably wouldn't be talking about going grocery shopping at Walmart and going to the zoo to see an alligator. That doesn't really seem like what the family did when they came over. I think the author did a really great job of only focusing on what they did when the relatives came to visit. Sometimes our brains just get so excited to write that we forget that we need to stay on the same topic. So think about these things when you're writing your story. Is your story going to just have one character, or is it going to have a lot of people? Is your story going to be one sentence? Maybe it'll start that way, but I bet as you think about it, there's going to be details that you can add. Go ahead and find your important people and places list and your heart map. These were things that we made in previous writing lessons, and these are going to be something that you're going to want to pull out every time that you get ready to write a new narrative story. These are kind of like your ideas, so that whenever you're stuck on what to write, you can take a look at what you wrote down and see if there's a good idea for you. Today, I'm going to focus on my dog. I got a puppy this year, and I would love to write a story to share it with all of my friends. And I'm going to remember that when I got my puppy, it wasn't just me. I had some other important people with me, like my family members and my friends. So I'm going to be sure to keep my people and places list out so that I can remember to include all of the characters in my story. This is a picture of my puppy. She's pretty cute, I think, and her name is Callie. The first thing I'm going to do when I'm starting to think about writing my own story is I need to pre-write. This is the first step, and it's kind of just like getting all of those ideas that I have in my brain and putting them on paper so that I don't forget. Sometimes I have so many ideas that whenever I start writing, I forget what they are. This is a really quick way to just think of jotting down your ideas for the beginning of your story, for the middle of your story, and for the end of your story. At the beginning of the story, I want to write about how we had to drive to Ohio to pick her up. That's a whole other state. And my dad came with me. And then we met Callie, which is the puppy. Notice I'm not writing complete sentences here. I'm just getting my ideas down. It might even be one word, or it might even be a picture. Whatever is easy to help you remember is what you need to write. In the middle of my story, now that we have the dog, I'm going to talk about our car ride home and my grandma and grandpa came to meet her. And I want to end my story with how we played all night long and then we went to sleep. I'm going to make sure that I stay on topic, and since I chose to write about getting my puppy, I'm only going to talk about the day I got my puppy. Nothing else. Once you have your pre-writing done and you have your beginning, your middle, and your end, you're gonna start your rough draft. Now, my rough draft looks like it has a lot of words, but I've been working on this for a really long time. So don't think that you need to write this much the very first time you pick up your pencil. This could take you a couple of days. I'm gonna read what I wrote. And then we're going to visit back to my other page. I wrote, "On May 5th, my dad and I drove to Ohio to pick up my new puppy." And that's what I said I wanted to write at the beginning of my story. The drive seemed like forever. I was so excited to meet my new puppy. I'm going to name her Callie. That's the beginning of my story. I talked about how I drove to Ohio, and I talked about how I met Callie. But there were some other details in there, and I went ahead and added those in a little bit later. I talked about how the car ride seemed like it was never going to end because I was so excited. The middle of my story. When we got home, a lot of my family wanted to meet her. My grandma and grandpa even drove to my house to meet her. She was very sleepy from the long drive. So once again, I talked about my grandma and grandpa coming, and I talked about how we took her home and she was so sleepy from the long drive. I didn't go to write my end yet. I'm still thinking and working on that, so that's not ready for me to share. But I really highly suggest putting your pre-writing paper somewhere in front of you while you're writing your story so that if you get stuck, you can look at that page. Mo Willems in the video above also talked about what he does when he gets stuck. You're going to do great, and remember, it doesn't have to be perfect. Writing is a process, and it's not going to be finished in one day. It takes Mo Willems almost a half a year to write a book. So, if you get stuck, maybe take a little break, get a snack, come back to it later. Your teacher's here to help, and we are so excited to see what awesome authors you are. Good luck, have fun, and remember to try your best. You can also pull up that virtual word wall that we have for you.